taking one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, gang. Thank you so much. Welcome to Tattletales. Thank you for tuning us in, and thank you. It's a nice way to start things off. I wasn't sure. I thought maybe this gentleman was with this young lady, and I thought I better set everything straight. It was just for fun. You understand that. Moving right along, we're going to have a really good time today. I promise you that. We have a new couple on the show, never been with us before, a couple of veteran couples who are going to win you lots of money, and here they are. Winning money today for the blues section, Colonel Buzz Aldrin and his wife, Beverly. I'm sorry. Winning money today for the banana section, Dan Rowan and his gal, Joanna Young. And winning money today from the red section, rookies on the show, first time here, from SWAT, Mark Shera and his gal, Barbara Deutsch. Well, welcome back to four of you, and welcome for the first time to you.
Thank you.
From SWAT and Barbara. And Buzz, you've got a movie now. They've made your book, Return to Earth.
That's right.
Into a
it's
film.
It's going to be showing on Friday the 14th of May.
Yes. All right. And who plays you?
Cliff Robertson does a smash-up job.
Oh.
Very terrific acting.
Yeah. Oh, that's wonderful. And also, I think maybe everybody would like to know, since the last time Buzz and Bev were here, you got married.
Right.
So now you are a married celebrity couple on Tattletales. And... if it goes the way it usually does, you're really going to have a rough day today.
We've been thinking about that.
That messes it up every time. All right, ladies, here's the first question. Dan, excuse me, I didn't mean to ignore you, sir.
It's perfectly all right. I'm used to it.
Oh. I greeted Joanna before backstage, so we've taken care of that. All right, if you're ready to go, ladies, the first question is for you. It's worth $150. Ladies, have you ever passed a man on the street who was so good-looking that you actually stopped and turned around for a second look? Yes or no? Okay, off you go. I've been told by my wife that if a lady does that, she means business usually. What do you think, Buzz? Has Bev ever done that?
She generally likes to look things over when she's impressed.
Yes.
I found that out.
Yes.
So I would think that, she would stop and take however much time it might take.
Yeah, so she has taken a second look on occasion. The answer is yes. Here she comes. Bev, have you ever done that? Have you ever passed a man on the street that was so good looking that just actually stopped and turned for a second look?
You better believe I
That's
have.
That's right. Okay. Well, you're right. So the jinx does not hold true.
Why,
does that mean, when you take a second look, does that mean that you're really interested or that you just want a better look?
Just want a better look.
Yeah,
I've
right.
got my guy, and I think he's terrific. But, gee, a good-looking man is something to look at.
Hey.
I like your attitude.
Yeah, I do, too.
The reverse holds true.
Yeah, now next time we'll ask for a third look, and then we'll see what happens. Dan, what will Joanna say?
She might even go back and ask him for lunch. No, she'll stop and go back and say, "Hi, how are you? You son of a gun, you're a nice-looking fella." Oh, yeah, she'd stop.
Okay, the answer is yes. Here she comes. Oh, I know. Joanna, have you ever passed a man on the street who was so good-looking that you took a second look?
Sure.
Yes, that's right. That was easy. Well, Mark, it's up to you to make this a three-way tie for the start of things.
Well, I think Barbara not only would stop the guy, she'd probably take him home, too.
Really?
That's how we met. No, that's not true. But yes, you would stop him.
I'm sorry, I haven't seen you girls earlier than today. Not that I would qualify.
Yes, she definitely would.
She would do that, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How did you meet her?
We were doing a show called Godspell on the road.
Yes.
And she was singing Day by Day to My Jesus.
Okay. I don't know why you made him your own personal. He's ours, too. You'll say that, yes, she would.
Definitely.
Here she comes. Barbara.
Hi.
Have you ever passed a man on the street who was so attractive that you had to take a second look?
I certainly have.
That's right. You're all right. Well, that was easy. No problem there. We split that three ways. That was a snap. We'll come back. But the rest of them ain't going to be a snap. You'll see. We'll see you in just a moment. Don't go away. This question is number two is coming up. We have a three-way tie, ladies. Do you ever refrain from saying something to your guy because you're afraid he's going to think it's dumb? Yes or no? Off you go. Dan?
Yes.
I don't know why it seems only appropriate to start with you. It seems like something Dick would say to you.
No, really, it would be something more I'd say to Dick, because he does say a lot of dumb things.
That's true.
And, but in our case, Joanna says anything to me that pops into her head. And very often she would tell me, that's a pretty dumb thing to say.
Yes.
So I'd say the answer to that was very positive. Yes, she has said things to me that she thought were dumb. Is
but
that your
I have
question?
Said, well, not really. I've said, do you ever refrain from saying something to your guy because you're afraid?
Would she stop from saying? No, no, no.
No, she wouldn't.
She'd never stop from saying
something. She'll say it even if she's positive it's dumb.
Speak right up. Yeah.
And say it. Okay, yeah. Here she comes. The answer is...
She'd leap to the opportunity.
Yes. Vital. As a matter of fact. Here she comes. Joanna, do you ever refrain from saying something to Dan because you're afraid he's going to think it's dumb?
I used to. He's pretty used to the dumb things I say. I don't edit my speech anymore, no.
That's right. That's what he said. Scared me to death. Are you saying that, like, when you first got to know him, you sort of didn't... had to be careful, maybe.
I'm safe now.
Yeah, now it's okay.
Yeah.
You're allowed a couple, eh?
Yeah.
Thank you, Joanna. Mark, what will Barbara say?
Well, I think she does. Yeah, I think she does, but I can usually call her on it, and I can usually get it out of her. But initially, she will edit herself, I think.
So she does... She
yeah,
is?
I think so.
She's a little worried about saying things to you.
A little worried just about... She thinks what she may say is dumb. Even if it isn't, she may... I think so, yeah.
Okay, so the answer is yes, she does refrain sometimes. Here she comes. Barbara, do you ever refrain from saying something to Mark that because you're afraid that he's going to think it's dumb?
Yeah.
That's right, that's it. Did you have something to add to that, Barbara?
No.
She's afraid it's going to be done,
that's
you see.
Right.
That's terrific. Buzz, what will Bev say?
Well, both of us have been around for a while, and we know the value of saying whatever we feel, regardless of what the other person might think. As a matter of fact, we want to really find out what the other person thinks. So we're making every effort we can to be just as thoroughly honest. So I'm sure that... She would not refrain from saying something.
The answer is no.
No.
Here she comes. So far, all tied up. Bev, we're tied up so far. If you get this one right, we've still got a three-way tie. Do you ever refrain from saying something to Buzz because you're afraid he's going to think it's dumb?
Well, I preface an awful lot of sentences with, boy, you're going to think this is dumb, but. So the answer is no.
That's right. You got it. Well, everybody got it. We split it three ways, and it is halftime. Gentlemen, step to the rear, if you will. We shall bring the ladies front and center and return with the second half of Tattletales. We've changed places after a halftime, and I have three beautiful, charming ladies with me. And the fellas are in the back, and you got a three-way tie, gang. Everybody's got $100. Can you hear me, Dan? Are you all right there?
Oh, you're really loud.
Yeah. Oh, I'm very sorry, Dan. I'll try to tone it down a little bit. Men, how many times would you say you've really been in love? Once? Twice? Three times? Or more than that? Okay? Really been in love. Off you go. I think the operative word here probably is really.
Really?
You picked up on that, eh?
Yeah.
Barbara, what will Mark say?
You can't help me on this.
I think Mark would say twice.
Think so?
I think he'd better.
Yeah?
That's okay.
Twice?
Yeah.
Gonna stick with twice?
I'm definitely gonna stick with twice.
You know of one other?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yes, you do.
I certainly do.
I don't think I'll pursue that any further.
No, I think you better not.
The answer is twice. Here he comes. Mark, how many times have you really been in love? Would you say once, twice, three times more than that?
That I'd admit to?
No, I didn't say that. I said, how many times would you say you've really been in love?
Twice.
Right. It's wonderful to see 122 people thrilled to death that he's been in love twice, isn't it? That's sweet. What a sweet thought. Bev, what will Buzz say?
Oh, God. This is really a rough one. I'm going to count very carefully and say Buzz is going to say three times.
Three times. Okay. What? That's... Oh, I see.
My fingers crossed for good luck.
I thought that was the
number.
Blue section.
That's two.
Okay, you'll say three times.
Three times.
Here he comes. Buzz, how many times would you say you've really been in love? Once, twice, three times, or more than that?
Once.
No, that's not what Beverly said.
Honey, I hope it's me, and I appreciate that. I'm not going to tell you what I said. You can wait and see it on the air.
Yeah, you'll see. Sorry about that, Buzz. Moving right along.
Well, that blows
Joanna,
my mind.
What will Dan say?
Three times.
Three times.
Yeah.
Exactly.
We've had fights over every one of them, so it's three times.
So it is three times.
I know.
Is that including you?
we fight over that sometimes. No, it's three.
It is three.
Yes.
Here he comes. Here's Dan. Dan, how many times would you say you've really been in love? Would you say once, twice, three times, or more than that?
I am happy to publicly state that this is the third and last.
That is it. You got it. Joanne and Dan, Barb and Mark split the pot in half. We have two-thirds of a tie and still a very close game. We're coming back with the $300 question and decide it. Don't go away. Okay, we have extra time today, which is good news for everyone here, because this question will be worth $150, and then we'll do a $300 question, all right? Okay, here we go. Men, when you telephone your gal during the day and ask her how goes it, which are you... Okay, good question, too. Think that one over and off you go.
The evil Arabs, it was Abu Hall, or Father of Terror. But in the beginning, experts say it was nothing more than an outcrop of unwanted...
Kind of like, come pick me up at so-and-so, or meet me someplace.
Really? Oh, that's nice.
I hope.
Gee, that's terrific.
He
I don't ever...
That.
Okay, you'll say the little pleasures,
the
eh?
Little pleasures.
Okay, here he comes. When you call Buzz and ask how goes it, which are you more likely to hear more about, the day's little pleasures or the day's little aggravations?
Well, we're together so much. We don't talk on the phone that much, but I would say, since it's a brief conversation, it would be the aggravations, and then we'd cover the...
No, that's not what Bev said.
Honey, when did I do that to you? Sweetheart, when did I...
See, Buzz, you had to go and get married. You can't play this game and be married.
You're right.
We had a couple on, been married 33 years and didn't get one right for a week.
Oh, my God.
It's absolute truth. I won't name names. Thank you, Buzz. I'm sorry. Joanna, what will
I
Dan
say? That whole week, I know who it is.
Do you? Yeah.
They were funny, though.
They were wonderful.
Gee, I do. I complain a lot. I complain things aren't good enough. Do you think he'd say complain? I really would like to say pleasures because it sounds so terrific. I'd be a terrific person if I could say that.
Make you look great on television, eh?
I complain.
It's a little aggravation.
Yeah.
All right. I think, I got a hand.
50-50
That's interesting. Here he comes. Shh. Dan, when you call home and ask how goes it, what are you more likely to hear, about the day's little pleasures or the day's little aggravations?
Yeah, it's such a tough question because we talk so seldom on the phone. We're together most of the time. And so I have to approach the question from whether she's more up than down, which may be the wrong approach to take to this question.
Mm.
But she really is such a happy, optimistic lady that I really... and she's also a complainer. It's tough. If I were to call her on the phone and say, hi, how's it going? She's going to say... she's probably going to tell me what's aggravated her.
That's right. That's what she said.
Tension, please.
What?
Big guess. Yes. What a guess that was.
Yeah, heart pumper that one was. Thank you, Dan. What will Mark say about it?
Well, he usually doesn't call me from the set, but if he did, I'd give him pleasure.
You would, eh?
Mm-hmm.
What? I want to know how you do that on the phone. Boy, if you could figure that one out, you could make $1 million, couldn't you?
I hope he gets this right.
Wow. Okay, you'll say a little pleasure. Here he comes. Mark, you telephone your gal and ask how goes it. And what are you more likely to hear, the day's little pleasures or the day's little aggravations?
Well, although Barbara's a very positive person, I think cause they're more interesting to hear the day's aggravations.
No, that's not what the lady said. Guess what she said? A little pleasure. Yeah. Joanna and Dan get the whole thing for the banana section. Okay. Hold it, gang. Hold it. You want the $300 question, don't you? Here it comes. So anybody can still win. Now, Buzz, you've got $100, and Mark, you've got $175, and Dan and Joanna have $325, but they can be caught. Men, does your gal ever think that you're angry with her when you really are not? Does she ever think that you're angry with her and you're really not? Think it over. Well, it's a... off you go. That's hard. Bev, what do you think Buzz will say?
I think that he will say yes. Because I'm super sensitive and sometimes he's just preoccupied with thinking about something and I'll say, what's the matter, honey? You're angry at me? And he'll say, no, what do you mean? So I think he'll say... whatever it is.
Right.
Yes?
You do think sometimes he's angry with you and
right.
and you're, he's really not.
Right.
Okay. And the answer is yes.
Yes.
Here he comes. Buzz, do you think Bev ever thinks that you're angry with her when you really are not?
I don't get angry at her too much. And if I did, she would know that for sure. What's the question again now?
Does Bev ever think that you're angry with her when you really are not?
No.
That's not what she said. She said sometimes she might misinterpret, that you're not thinking about something else and you may answer brusquely or something. And
she sure misinterpreted that time.
Did misinterpret that one.
Honey.
No question about it. And now he's angry with you, Bev. No.
Honey. I'm angry.
No, not at all. But that's a hard question.
Kidding.
It's very hard. See, he took it as like a fight rather than a slight
don't,
thing.
Don't explain for him. It's okay.
No,
I'll talk to him later.
But maybe it'll help Barbara. What do you think? What will Mark say?
I know, we don't really miss a communication very often. This might be the first.
Anybody who gets pleasure on a phone ain't going to miss communications, I can tell you that.
Now I'm going to aggravate him on the phone from now on. I think he would say yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sometimes you do think he's angry with you and he's really not.
Yeah.
Okay, here he comes. No, we got Dan. We don't want Dan.
You may not want
Dan. There he is. No, Joanna says, maybe you don't want Dan, but... Mark, do you think Barbara ever thinks that you're angry with her when you really are not?
Yes.
That's right. You got it. Oh, yes. Now it gets interesting. Because if you get this right, well, then you have it for the bananas, Joanna. But if you do not... then Mark and Barbara will get it all and win for the red section.
My mouth is twitching like this. I hate that part. I don't know. What do you think? I don't know.
You really don't?
He has the kind of face that when you look at it, you always think there's something wrong. I always say, are you mad at me? And he'll say, no, I have that kind of face.
Mean is
wait a
saying.
Minute. It's adorable, but he does have it. Okay.
And yes, it is.
You got it.
Here he comes. Dan, does Joanna ever think that you're angry with her when you really are not?
To quote the great movie Seven Beauties opening lines, oh yeah.
That's right. You got it. to Ed and Dan Barber and Mark Spitz the $300. However, time is up. The Bananas win it. We will come back in just a moment and give the Bananas their money. That's considerable, too. See you in just a second. Dan and Joanna won $475. We had a grand, a total of 1,475 big ones. Thank you all. You were splendid. And thank you so much for tuning us in on Tattletales. Bert Convy saying so long. I'll see you next time. Thank you.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Taken one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. I thank you all and welcome to Tattletales. All right, gang. It's nice to have you with us. Thank you for tuning in. Please. Hold on. If you keep that up, you'll win less money. We won't have time for questions, and you don't want to do that. We have some wonderful people who indeed are going to win you a lot of money, and here they are, winning money today for the blues section, Helen Rayburn and her husband, Gene Rayburn.
Oh, yeah.